Hello there, everyone, and welcome back. That was a heartbreaking loss, as far as I'm concerned, dealing with that mirror match against the Space Marines. Although, in the end, it was still damn good, well-earned battle. Or well-hard-fought battle, rather. But in the end, there were multiple things that went wrong with that with the ending there, losing my convoy ship. Because, yeah, sure, I did not focus on the engines there, but in all honesty, my vanguards could have rammed it when I was doing my bombing runs with the torpedoes, throw it off course. I could have had my convoy ship not go out of border to keep its boosters going, potentially dodging the ram. There were a couple other things that I messed up on that could have changed the flow of that battle. Especially in that video, his level 10 strike cruiser was heavily damaged just after he did the boarding run, so anything to have delayed him another 2 seconds would have won me that match. Because he had no weaponry, he had nothing else he could have done, especially being stuck in out of the border as well. So it was really my battle to lose despite all that. On the plus side though, we are now level 4. What doesn't bode well for me is the fact that I don't have the renown to actually get my second cruiser. Mainly because I invested 200 renown on my damn hunters, so that's kind of biting me in the ass a little bit. Not to mention the fact that I need another 100 renown to actually equip it with the skill slots to get it fully operational. At least in fighting form. But nonetheless, my squad did survive that entire battle completely intact, no heavily damaged, and we're well on our way for our second vanguard reaching level 4. And two more here getting well underway, but they'll need a couple matches. So, what's the plan here now? Unlocking my second strike cruiser, and I'm thinking of utilizing the one with the two, was it Thunderhawks? I forget, that's probably the Mark 1? I'll have to double check, but the one that gives me two Thunderhawk squadrons. And using a combination with the other strike cruiser, because as I mentioned time and time again, and oh god. Oh, I think I know how this is going to go, isn't it? Only problem is, I don't know, does he have 400 points or does he have 450? Because if he has 400, that means he has a custodian and he's more than likely going to use it. Which could be a bit of a problem, which I'm defender anyway, so mobility is probably key here, quite frankly. But I have so many points, how do I even do this? How do I even start with this? I have mobility. I could just play the waiting game and just outmaneuver him if he does go with that. If he has air cache though, that could still be an issue, but I have enough cruisers and Stormhawks to deal with bombers to kind of fight him off at least at a distance. So I should be in the clear, but any massive burst damage will kill me immediately. So what I should have done was made my Admiral ship the actual level 4 light cruiser. At least that way, if I do lose this battle, at least my level 3s are still going to get the experience. As it stands now, I chose a level 3 because I wasn't considering I have the points for a 4th light cruiser. So how do I want to do this? Let's just pick a direction. He will have seeker missiles, but again, I'm going to have so many Stormhawks to shoot them down. That's not an issue. Damn it. I don't need updates, Windows. Shut up already. I got more important things to do. So, huh, interesting. I see two cruisers. I don't have to engage them at all. Although I could consider it. Let me dodge these seeker missiles first, because now my position is kind of bad for that, isn't it? Show us the enemy. And I want to keep my admiral ship safe anyway, so
ready for battle.
Okay, he does have three ships of some kind, so it looks like he has a Dalef.
Hold course.
If I want to guess, he has a Dalef. Everyone turn around already, damn it. Everyone turn around. So he has bombers and that, but I got defensive fighters for this. So I'm okay. I can weather the seeker missile storm. Hell, I'm already revealed, so why not reveal myself more, quite frankly. I have the mobility, and if he does not have air cache, he cannot catch me. Not exactly exciting, but he's got the level advantage, so... So keep everything close together for the Stormhawks. Okay, was that all you got there? I gotta make sure I don't lose. Yeah, he's just all Earth cash, so that's fine. I still got boosters. And we could kill these wardens, so that confirms at least one of them's a Daleth. I want to say it's a Daleth anyway, since I'm seeing a second cruiser with fighters that aren't even being launched. So I think we're okay here. Not exactly exciting, but considering the Jurassic power swing against Tau I'm gonna have to fight, I'm not really prepared for this because of how fragile I could be with these against these bombers. I do have Stormhawks. I don't have a lot of Stormhawks now, at least. And he killed his own warden, so thank you for the free renown. And I have better mobility even with his air cache, so that's not a problem. And he made perfectly clear he has at least two Earth cache ships, so not an issue. Not exactly exciting, but I'm not even sure how to fight Tau just yet when they have access to such burst damage. Stormhawks are a good deal. They play a huge role. And I'm just gonna warp on out, can I? Not for another 15 seconds. So I'll get out in a moment, and he has no lightning strikes to cancel that. Unless he has bombing potential on his ships. Now, let's end this off already. Just take the hits, and we'll call the wrap. Not really much else to say, really. Simple as hell. I did not pay attention to his level. I apologize for it being anticlimactic, though. I could have gotten more aggressive with my torpedoes, but hell, my own starting precision kind of, ruined that attempt, because otherwise I would have two of my own light cruisers just hit each other. That would not bode well. And if he had a messenger, there would have been no way I could have broke through that without getting close. And we already know the raw firepower he has, so it's going to take a little bit of getting used to fighting high-level Tau to know how much I can get away with. Because I have the armor to deal with the railguns, but on the flip side, they have so many railguns when they have so many cruisers, so it will be a matter of learning how aggressive and how much I can get away with punishing Tau. Because once their fighters are gone, that opens up a window for bombing runs quite a bit. It's just a matter of a custodian or a messenger to kind of ruin the efforts afterward if my torpedoes can do the damage they need to. Thankfully, Stormhawks are going to be really useful for that because they're 6,000 unit proximity range, so they can shoot down the fighters if I'm okay with losing them. And like I was saying before, I was planning on going for this ordnance launch bay for the extra Thunderhawks to complement my other strike cruiser, I think. Although torpedoes is still going to be nice. This opens up a little more flexibility in upgrades, maybe. I don't know, I was planning on fielding one of these anyway. It's just a question on the synergy. And we actually have the renown with that victory, thankfully, to get the upgrades I want. So it was not looking very good for me entering level 4, not having a renown for even a second cruiser, but that was easily rectified with that quick match, so we're looking good. Now I just gotta get it leveled up, so I can start upgrading these Thunderhawks, because I'm probably going to go full on out with the bombing Thunderhawks and kind of use them to kind of like do a lot of damage potentially when I don't need to board. Whereas the torpedoes are going to be a little more trickier, and the torpedoes can also be avoided. Especially the boring torpedoes. At this point now, a lot of people know how to avoid those weaponry. But things have flipped around. Now we're fighting someone lower level. And I'm just one damn point off for fielding two strike cruisers. Ooh, that was painful. Nonetheless, I still want to get that level one in. Is it the right choice against Chaos, though? That's the real question. Because he's either going to have a lot of lances, or a lot of fighters, or bombers even, so... I, without a doubt, am going to need a beacon of some kind, though, to help spot them if he is going to kite me. I'm just not going to... With the lack of a second cruiser, though, I'm not going to be able to bring the shields down to hopefully stick a beacon on them. So there begs a question. Let me try field level 3. I don't even have the points. This is going to stink. Because who knows how many points he's going to get out of this bonus. I may have to consider this one a futile attempt. I may have to abandon warp out. If it's looking like victory is impossible for at least the level 1 cruiser. If I could get the level 3 out intact, then that'll be at least one more level 4 for me. But as it stands now, this is a very awkward positioning. If I had just that one goddamn extra point, it's like playing Tau all over again with the Protector and a Sauce. I think that's what it was, right? I couldn't feel the Protector and a Sauce together because it was a few points off. I honestly can't remember. Either way, it's not pleasant. I thankfully have Stormhawks easily deal with the bombers. And I want to say, if he's level 2, he should only have like 30-40 point bonus, so I want to say he has two light cruisers, a cruiser light cruiser, and two frigates. Two light cruisers would be kind of nice, though. At least that evens the odds a little bit for my strike cruiser, at least health-wise, because armor is not going to do crap in this fight. It doesn't matter what kind of armor Space Marines have. If you got lances, if you got bombers, if you got an entire armada of weaponry available to you that pierces my armor, then I'm just crippled right off the bat. I'm kind of handicapped from just having that extra armor, so it's going to get a little awkward. But boarding them should be pretty damn effective when I start getting those board attempts in.
Hold course.
And I do have beacons to spot if necessary. I also have torpedoes to kind of flush them out. Only one torpedo, mind you, but I still have torpedoes. Now, the big question, does he come after me or not? I can easily find out when I get this damn vanguard turned around. To see if he's following suit or not. Because it looks like I got one hit in. So a little bit of damage is a good start, and he is coming for me. Now, I should be within the extended sensor range to be detected, so the plus side, he does not look like to have that, at least if those are his cruisers. And I could force it. Oh, he's doing this easy for me. Okay, let's kill the frigate, because it's the most vulnerable. And try and get ready for this. Because my Stormhawks are going to die quickly. I'm identified. He does have a cruiser. He has two level ones, so that doesn't bode well for him, I think. That is one down. That is a good start as far as I'm concerned. Am I hit in? Does he have extended sensors? They're all level one. Okay. I was wondering. I should have been hit in. So let's chip down his fleet. Oh, I'm inside the bomb, damn it. Now, what do I have to be careful? He has a slaughter, so he's got the close range variant, which my armor's going to be decent here. Kill the weaponry, because that's actually... He has two weapons linked together. I should have braced for impact. And he killed my deck, so there goes my brace for impact, I just realized, for my vanguard. I would like to kill the other frigate, because right now I am getting murdered by the slaughter. Hint its name, huh? I do have the speed to just evade, but I have no brace for impact or salt running, but I can't get out of range of the dang slaughter. Do some damage. Hit it. Hit it good, because I got the armor advantage. He did not brace for impact or do anything, so... Get this vanguard to live, is the idea. Heavily damaged, so that's a good start. Now, let's hunt this thing down. He's a level 1. He's already bailing, so... Should I let him live? I let him live. But this engine is not... It's making me more charitable, I'm going to admit right now. I want vengeance for that dead engine. Yeah, and the lances are still hitting me, so I need to kind of hide my ship if I'm going to have any hope of doing damage. So, shields are down, bombardments are underway. This is looking promising. So, get turned around. Not exactly the most efficient way to hide, but I want to at least keep the ship alive. That would be kind of nice, if you ask me. And now with 3 boarding attempts on that cruiser, I want to kill extra weaponry. And so far, half its weaponry is gone, or was. I take that back. God damn it. So this ship is all but crippled now. I have no bombardment cannon. I think I have to abandon it. I don't have the health to deal with that dang cruiser. And I don't even have a generator, I just realized, so warping out is going to take an eternity. So let's abandon this, preserve my ships. This is not the result I would have liked. I am about to get repairs though, so maybe I can afford to let the Vanguard keep fighting. I just gotta get the repairs off. Alright. He doesn't want to play away, fine, I was generous. Now if I could get an extra board, that would be great. Because right now I don't even have fission. I did make out of the bomb though. I'm gonna make him pay for this. Like I said, I was feeling charitable, but he doesn't want to play that way. I'm about to have repairs, but is it going to be in time? Because I'm about to get heavily damaged in a moment. So let's try it again. He did waste his warp out. I have repairs underway to help mitigate the damage. It is mitigating the damage, right? It is soaking a bunch of damage. Oh, and the generator did come on, thankfully. So let's try and punish him then. I have no generators. I probably should just run off with this cruiser now, quite frankly. Now let's kill the frigate. Boarding torpedoes are about to hit. I have no fission, unfortunately, but that's okay. That's okay, he's not utilizing assault running, so I'm not out of this yet. And I have the same speed as him, so this is working really well for me. It's once he's in the nebula cloud, I'm not going to do the damage I would like. But as it stands now, with him chasing me, he can't do crap. I gotta identify. I'm gonna make sure he gets spots for those boring torpedoes, because damn it, that sense of range is so limiting. Holy crap. More torpedoes did hit. That was a bit of a waste. And where's my weaponry?
Repositioning.
Why is my weaponry not firing? I have broadside cans, for crying out loud. Do you think? You figured they would hit. Now, my only gambit is to try and disable the weapons.
underway.
Which, go figure, did not hit. It destroyed the deck, but not really much else.
Repositioning.
Although, that hit me as well, so that's not terrible. I benefit from this exchange, right?
Space Marines ready.
I'm gonna hope. Destroy some weapons, please. I have the boarding advantage. You think it would work?
Moving to position.
Nope, nothing. I don't even think I got a single critical hit aside for a dang deck. And now I pretty much lost the ship because of that failed attempt. Unless the weapons can die right now. Of course, now decides to destroy the weapons. Both of them. All that he had left was one macro turret. Just as my... as a big middle finger. Oh my. At least the level 1 cruiser made it out. Could have kept it there, probably, but I think the level was more valuable. Should have really considered getting the level 3 out, because it was due for its 4th level. Ah, that's a shame. Destroying the prow, crippling it there. Belt armor is so valuable, isn't it? Because that kills the bombardment cannon and anything else I have on the prow. And it's also lost in warp, so I'm contemplating just having that belt armor just because of that. Oh well. Not much can do about that. I have 2 ships out of the battle, so I'm not going to have either for the next match. But once we get everything back underway, I can at least start utilizing maybe my double cruiser strategy. Hell, I would have won just for having that one extra point. It makes me wish I took the Lance strike cruiser instead. Or even just one with the torpedoes. 2 strike cruisers alone would have given me the power I need just to break through. Because I couldn't even field a frigate in that match using a vanguard, could I? It's not looking like it. 30 points. 30 points difference, not much, and this requires 50, so yeah. I couldn't even afford a frigate. Which also would have helped, I think. Or maybe I could have fielded a frigate and never paid attention. That would have been... well, I would have afforded a frigate if I'd gone for the torpedo, the Mark II. So as my obsession getting the level, the Mark I leveled up, that was probably my biggest downfall. Unless you can really blame me, I need to kind of get them leveled up so they can be useful. Now, we are looking at maybe someone that's a level higher than me. I'm assuming now that I'm level 4, I have access to the 500 point battles. Now, dealing with these bombers are a big deal. But of course it requires fielding all my cruisers. Which, for Stormhawks, is not terrible, and they all have torpedoes, so there is a nice turnaround factor, a comeback. I don't know what the term you would use, where basically, I can't do damage to them so long as his fires are up. But as soon as those fires go down, I'm going to have such a momentum swing with my torpedoes right in his white-ass face. Because after all the townships are white as hell. So I can abuse that factor amazingly if I can kill his fighters and any kind of messengers he may have. But now I'm regretting letting that damn slaughter cruiser live. I was being generous and he was trying not to do the same. Go figure.
Repositioning.
So, let's get these torpedoes underway. I have the mobility to easily dodge that, but what's my positioning? I actually want to go this way. More nebula clouds to utilize. It squanders my mobility a little bit. But this looks like the better positioning, at least better fallback position. Gotta be careful that one nebula cloud, but I have the dumbfire weaponry to kind of justify it. So, if I had to guess, a protector and 3 sauces. If I had to guess. It seems likely, it doesn't seem unreasonable at least. Which means no messengers and not really a lot of fighter defense or anti-missile defense, so just dumbfire torpedoes is kind of the way to go, quite frankly. I just gotta be good about how I aim these torpedoes to get maximize the damage or maximize the situation he's put under.
Ready for battle.
Torpedo wave 2 is underway. We'll see what kind of damage this does. Time to unleash the Stormhawks. Not that they're really significant now, but at least it gives me time to refresh them for like a second wave. But so far this is looking really promising. I was kind of neglecting the fact that there may have been staff alloy at play, but thankfully there's only 4 ships in the field. I was kind of almost forgot that there could have been a Bastion or something to wreck my day. So we're all in the clear. No one needs to panic. Let's keep these torpedoes going. And hope I can hit. Because so far torpedoes are looking promising, and even if he hides in a nebula cloud, that's not going to do much. Again, I require no sensors to actually hit him. Although this is likely a spot. So, unless it hits the structure, is it going to hit? It's looking like it might hit. Unless it's on the edge. Oh my god, what a huge whiff. I don't want to criticize him too much, but that was a wasted opportunity to spot me. And he just revealed himself. Okay, so someone's feeling the pressure. Okay, so he's playing that route. So I see what he has. That one actually missed, so that was good so far. Now, let's get the Thunderhawks going. Okay, that was 3, so he only has 1 more left. And let's get this boring torpedoes going. Armor's up. So, let's try dodge and try mitigate the damage, although I repaired a little too soon, it looks like. Mitigate the value of that earth cache a little bit. So, my boarding missiles don't want to fire. I thought I auto-cached these stupid things. So keep hugging the building, just keep evading, and actually I can just hide in here some. Do I kill engines or do I kill everything else? I can kind of kite them all day, so... Torpedoes was looking promising at least, but he has repair drones, so actually... Whatever kill repair drones would be good. And he killed my deck, go figure. Go figure, hiding behind a structure is not going to work. I should have learned that from the damn beacon.
Astartes vessel ready.
This is working, right?
I am listening.
Nope, I'm still getting hit. Go figure. Go figure. All this protection, I'm still getting heavily damaged. Unless that was from bombers. What has the repair drones? I'm just wondering. That one there, and what's his associate to the hull? So I just have to heavily damage him. Easier said than done, right? Now launch my Thunderhawks array, you stupid thing. Did you not launch? I don't think it launched anything. Or maybe it did, I wasn't paying attention. So just outrange him, try to outrange him because I have the better mobility. Gotta be careful of the earth cache weaponry though. Because he can't hit me with that and I don't know when that cooldown is coming back up.
At your command.
But once I start chipping him down, that's going to heavily mitigate his damage value a little bit.
Show us the enemy. Moving to position.
Now I just got to keep my ships together to help mitigate the seeker missiles. Okay, brace for impact is on, because these missiles are eventually going to do some damage, so let's mitigate that. And the protector is slowly getting chipped down. Deck's gone, that doesn't do much. And keep on moving, group on up. And keep on bombarding. Those ion cans are still going to do a bit of work, so I need to be careful. Now, can I just fire straight up torpedoes at him? Because he wants to burst this down, so... And my real... Yeah. Let's see, that's going to be a good hit. Can I do another hit? I don't care about the disruption. But I have no boosters, so... Let's see if that kills something for me. So close. None of those torpedoes hit. That was so close. I should have just gone for boring torpedoes, I think. Now, all I need to do... I guess is try and reload. Maybe not smart idea or not. Because these railguns can still hit me. And his engines are down too, that's why I'm having issues hitting him.
Suspending tactical cogitators. Show us the enemy. All power to engines.
Weapons gone. He missed that railgun. I think he missed. But railguns are starting to kill me here. Belt armor gone. That has a reload, so that may not have been a good idea. So this looks like it might still be a loss there, but I feel like the prospect is good. It's just a matter of being able to focus them down. Because even though it's that protector is almost dead, it doesn't mean much when it can still use its railgun and weaponry. Because it has such range right now. So, time to abandon this for my own sake, for my own fleet. I should have braced for impact, that was a huge mistake. Oh well, this was a good learning experience, I'm happy with this. Can I survive with all the ships though? If only I had been a little more diligent trying to snipe down that protector, because he still got railguns off and he still had the range to shoot me. But all my ships made out intact. Probably three of them are going to be lost in warp, but still. I'm really happy with how that turned out. I just need execution to be a little bit better. I wonder if I should be thankful he didn't go with his second protector there, trying to shoot down my torpedoes. But nonetheless, if I can somehow just find some good window to hit him with some straight up dumbfire damage torpedoes rather than trying to bore him to death, then that would do better for me, because that actually would kill his repair drones. I think it would also kill his heavy railgun, unless that's probably connected to the prow, and I don't think I ever really checked. But we got three level fours now. This is not a bad thing at all for me. We got a lot of heavily damaged ships, unfortunately, but all of these I can actually repair if I want to invest the renown for it. So a good learning experience there, I want to say.